What's up, guys? Welcome back to To-Do List Minecraft. This is a special bonus episode coming out on the same day as the previous episode because I feel bad about not having the footage of killing the Ender Dragon. So we are going to kill the Wither today, and we're going to go off To-Do List. We don't need the To-Do List anymore. Who cares about it? I do. We need the To-Do List. It's our only hope. So we're not really going off To-Do List. We're just skipping a few to-dos. We're going to go and do this before we do something else that's kind of, I guess, more important. Nothing specific, I just mean that, you know, we're going to go do this regardless of whatever else we have to do. So, what are we doing? How are we killing the Wither? So, what I'm going to do is make a mob spawner and then put witch water in it so that that... Okay, so, let me be clear. A mob spawner obviously spawns mobs. If you put witch water down, it will convert a skeleton into a Wither skeleton. And if we make a mob spawner with high enough rates, we can just kill Wither skeletons for hours until we get enough Wither skulls to fight the Wither. If... for some reason I lose the footage of fighting the Wither, I will just fight the Wither again. This is why I'm doing it, because if anything goes wrong, I'll just do it again. I'll keep doing it again until we've got footage of it, because it makes up for not having footage of fighting the Ender Dragon, I think. I also want a mob spawner. I want it to look nice. I want it to be a couple of nice things. And it's going to play a role in our future Let's Play, and especially in our future town. I'd like something very specific with our mob spawner. So... the first step we need is to make a silk touch shovel or a silk touch pick or a silk touch anything really, and go and pick up the dirt that is under there. You can see it's still there because some places are still on fire where the creep spawns back in. I accidentally dug that out, which was a mistake. Oh well, it should still be under there anyway, otherwise that wouldn't have spread. So I'm going to make a silk touch pick. We've got levels and we should have more levels soon. I'm going to make, basically what I'm going to do is make a shovel. Check if I get silk touch, make a shovel, check if I get silk touch, make a shovel, check if I get silk touch, over and over again until I get it, because we need it. So I will be doing that, and we'll be back when we have silk touch. Okay, it was a very grindy experience, but we finally have our silk touch pick. I think it's silk touch efficiency on breaking, which is helpful. And now we can see if we can grab some of this. It's been nighttime, so there's some left. I should probably kill the creatures that are around. Jesus, how many are there? Well, this is exactly why we want this soil. There's plenty of... What am I being attacked by right now? Oh, there's the skeleton here. Good. Okay, let's try and grab some of this soil. Okay, perfect. Let's get as much as we can. And now we'll no longer have the problem at night where everything's turning into death. Okay, there is all of the available cursed soil. 37, that's great. It means this area is no longer going to be quite as dangerous. It also still looks like a mess. Maybe we'll put some sort of sanctuary here, like a shrine or something. I don't know, just to... as if the area was evil and now it needs to be fixed. I worry because some of the cursed earth had spread downwards. Like, there was cursed earth here underneath more cursed earth. I worry that there's a cave underneath here and the cursed earth has spread to it. But if it happened, it happened. Now we need to go and find a place to put our spawner. And I'd like it to be sort of like a fortress area. And the spawner is being handled by the warriors or the soldiers of that fortress. So I'm going to grab the resource we need. And I guess we're going to go somewhere over there. Okay, this is going to be the site of our mob spawner, and of also, I guess, a castle type thing, something to that effect anyway. It's definitely going to be a new village anyway. There's our home. We can see we're not far. It's just this little pathway down here. We're going to probably put a road in or something like that. I'm going to build the mob spawner basically inside of this mountain, because I would like, the effect I want to go for is like a cave entrance that has to be guarded because loads of mobs constantly come out of it, and then have a fort around here that fights off the mobs. That's what we're going to go for, and I'm going to start building that, and then I guess I'll cut back when we are on, because I'm going to hollow out a part of this mountain first. I guess we'll cut back when we are on the section we need to be on. I'll not build the mob spawner. I want you guys to see how I do the mob spawner, because it's pretty cool. It's not my design, it's just a cool design. So we'll cut back when we're building the mob spawner, and then I will see you in a second. Okay, I've grabbed more resources and everything's charged up again. I should be able to show you the progress we've made. So you might see that there's been a bit of a change in the landscape over there. I'm not quite certain I'm happy with it. Because I had to dig out the inside of the mountain, it had to be a certain set of dimensions. I've had to break the front of the mountain, which is not a thing I usually like doing, because I'd rather have it sort of innocuous. But I've made it so that it's like a big block that's sticking out of the landscape with dirt on top. I've put the dirt so that it's sort of like falling off. And maybe I'll put some vines and stuff like that to make it settle in. But it also might be possible, I might in the end just replace this with smooth cobblestone, smooth stone, And I'm going to change it out like that because I'm not a big fan of the appearance right now. We'll see. So here is the setup for our mob spawner. I've replaced all of the areas that had any dirt that could contact the like touch the cursed soil. I've replaced with cobblestone because I didn't want it to infect the outside. What we have here then is five blocks of dirt across, and then there are these wooden slabs, and these are to prevent spiders from spawning. Monsters can spawn all these spaces, but spiders need 4x4, I think, to spawn. And then the next layer is going to be here. So there's two spaces of room for a zombie to spawn. This will all be cursed soil. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dig out a block of each place and then just put the cursed soil down and then run like hell and seal the thing up. So it's going to be as many floors as high as I can get, repeating this over and over again. And then, oh, that means there's some dirt touching that. I don't know how that happened. Hopefully it won't happen again. So yeah, this is going to be as many floors high as I can manage. And then we're going to put on the sides here one or two trap doors and then open them. So where there's... I realised I made a mistake by making this three wide. I was going to say we put trap doors on so that monsters will try and wander across to the other side and then fall in here and be swept out. But I realised that because it's three wide, they won't consider their trap door accessible. They'll consider that if they walk off, they'll just fall into nothing. So I'll have to put this space in the middle, which is fine. It's more spawning room. But it's just, I hadn't realised, I made a mistake, but oh well. So basically, the trapdoors you put on the inside here, and they think they can walk through, they try and walk down, and they just fall into the gap in the middle and get swept out. So I'm going to repeat all the floors, and then I will show you the process of putting in the cursed earth, and we will be done. I'm going to take one block of this out so I can put the cursed earth in. Okay, I will see you in a second. Okay, so we are ready to go, basically. I've put everything in, we're on the top floor. What we have to do on each floor is come in, knock out the torch, put down a piece of cursed earth here, here, and then when we go down here, and then do the same thing on the next floor. We have to do it quick because otherwise we will die. Things are going to get messy really quick, so we'll do our best. So we knock out this torch, come across here, put that down, and then we're going to build down to the next layer. That should be good. And then we put these down. Okay, I realized I made a mistake by putting the slabs in the middle, but I just make some quick changes, but we're okay now, but it was a stressful process. So I'm gonna keep going, almost finished. Knock out the torch, put the cursed soil down and get the hell out of Dodge. I took out the pillar in the middle because we can actually do the rest without any hassle. Oops, I'm just gonna mine that out because we don't need to worry about it. That should be everything. We can look up and see. Yep, this should all start spreading soon and this will get better and better rates. We should get out because soon it'll get pretty dangerous. We can just kill this one guy. Now we need to block this thing up before anything bad happens. And this is how it will be. They'll keep being stuck there. Maybe I'll move it one bit forward. Okay, mobs are starting to spawn. I can hear spiders spawning, but I can hear them spawning and then dying, which isn't a problem. I don't know why they're spawning. I set it up so that they shouldn't be able to. Maybe I made a mistake and there's a block there in there that a spider can spawn on. As the cursed earth spreads, this will get better and better rates. We've already got one creeper spawn, and they're also like super creepers because of the... Not like actual super creepers, but they've got enchantments on them which make them faster and stronger, I think, because of the cursed soil. So, not great, but you know, good rates. I left a torch. Okay, I realised I left a torch. I'm going to have to go back in and sort that out. I'm avoiding going close because if a skeleton shoots a creeper, this thing will blow up. And blowing up is typically bad. But I can absolutely kill them if I get in close enough. Trouble is... Yep, okay, that's what we don't want to avoid. We can't actually pick up anything, but that's fine. I didn't actually want to be able to pick up things manually from this. In fact, I don't want to stand here and hit creepers. What I want to do is make a grinder, which is pretty simple. Doesn't take that much effort to put together. A grinder will automatically chew these guys up, take their XP, and give us their items, which is great. So we need to give the grinder power and also somewhere to put the XP that it generates, which is fine. Those things are easy to make. We've already made basically all that stuff before. All we have to do is make it and put it here. So what I'm going to do is put together the area that's going to surround this place, and maybe some NPCs as well. That was an explosion. Or looks fine anyway. We're going to put together the area that's around this place and the grinder because we can't let mobs keep building up for too long. And then we'll be back. It's basically going to be, though, I'll tell you, a castle that goes around here with guard towers and maybe some NPCs. Hopefully I can get the NPCs to convert their power from the Ancient Warfare mod to RF, which is the, I think, the power that the grinder uses. And then we can have the NPCs actually farm this place, which I'd really like. So I'm going to get to work on that, and then we'll be back. We are back. I've released these guys because the area is now safe. I need to take out all these torches because I don't like the way they look. But yeah, they're released and they're going to go do their work. I haven't set up the couriers yet, but I'll probably do that because we have to wait on our mob spawner to get to work. It's been going for a while, but we need to wait for it to get enough wither skulls. From what I've seen, we have two. It's going quite slowly because... So I'll explain when I get there. I've started on a road that leads to the mob spawner, but if you follow this road, you get to this little castle. And I wanted to have like an actual little army here, and they're all working the mob spawner, but unfortunately I couldn't get Ancient Warfare to work in this area. I don't know why, really, and I won't have much help. I'm going to close the gate just for safety. Yeah, it's not very easy to troubleshoot. There we go. It's not very easy to troubleshoot because there's not much resources out there for Ancient Warfare. I think, in fact, it's even unsupported, so... we're not going to find much help with it, but I couldn't get it to work. So for now, I've just put three survival generators down. Let me show you the buildings. So I managed to get these three horses, or actually I got two horses, then bred one. I wanted some like stables here. So I put this in. It also like breaks up the area a little bit. I got four gas tiers and made a reusable safari net, which just allows us to grab horses without like having to push them here or lead them anywhere or ride them or anything like that. So I haven't even tamed these horses. They're just in there. So, let's show you the barracks. This is where, if we can get Ancient Warfare to work, this will be the home for the soldiers. They won't actually sleep, they don't use the beds, but I like the way it looks. All these chests are empty, but I like the way it looks. So, this is our mob spawner. I had to make some changes because we were having a problem where, randomly at some points, creepers were being turned into super creepers by lightning strikes. I think maybe if there's a certain number of creepers on Cursed Earth, it automatically sends a firebolt down, but that meant that light was appearing because it started fires, which was burning the rest of the cursed earth. So what I had to do was put cursed earth under the slabs, turn the slabs into stone slabs so they didn't burn up. And now the cursed earth under the slabs, when everything else burns away, the cursed earth under the slabs reinstates the rest of the cursed earth. So it's not the best system because we lose a lot of productivity when the slabs start going. When the lightning hits, but it's a solution to a problem. So there's also been some explosions in there, which is understandable. I'd like to make some changes to this system, but for now it'll work. Like I said, we have to use survival generators. I've put coal, a full stack, in, and it's been running for a while. It goes up very slowly, so it doesn't work very quickly. These just aren't enough power to handle all these mobs. So this is what it's been running. It's generated all this stuff apart from this I put in there. I don't know what a mystery egg is. It generated all this stuff, which will be really useful to us, especially stuff like the treasure bags. A nightmare book. I don't know what half this stuff is, but I'm looking forward to finding out. Because of the fact that I put witch water down here, any skeletons that drop in will become wither skeletons. Any creepers that drop in become super creepers, so we've got to be careful about going in there ever again. But that means we're able to make wither skeleton heads. And that means we'll be able to fight the wither pretty soon. We're also getting cool drops like crossbows and bones and stuff like that. The bones are quite important because I'm hoping to set up some trade between this village, which will be a village at some point when I get Ancient Warfare working in this area, and that village over there. Okay, this is basically it. So the shower exists so that I can whack this on here, and it should... Oh, my mistake. I thought that the essence could be immediately converted into XP. Apparently it can't. That's fine. I know that you can do a lot of things with the essence. The essence is how we can spawn things. If we needed, for example, to spawn a bunch of, wither skeletons, we could use this essence to do it. I'll probably have to replace the tanks regularly, but it goes quite slowly anyway, so it's no problem. I may even just have this go into a trash can, like have it automatically fit, like tipped out, because we don't need the essence right now. So what we have to do is wait for these to fill up. I mean, we've got other chests, so we can wait as long as it takes. We need one more wither skeleton, then we can fight the wither. Wither skull, then we can fight the wither. In the meantime, while I'm waiting for that to happen, I might build... So I want a castle here. And I want a castle in this world anyway, and this seems like as good a place to put it as any. That's why I've got this pathway here. I don't know what this building's going to be, but it's going to be something. I'd like a castle here. I might just start building the castle. There's gonna be lots of things in it. Like, I like collecting mobs. Like, going to the Nether and grabbing some of the more interesting mobs and putting them in a I think it's called a captor's safari net. Oh, a jailer's net, which is a safari net that means a creature won't despawn. I like capturing them and putting them in glass tanks as like a collection. Maybe that's a bit weird, and you can look into that. You like decide, make your own opinions about whether that's creepy or not. But that's one of the things I want to do. So, and they'll probably be on display in this castle. I'm going to make a castle here, and when we do have a village here, the castle will be also where the food is stored. So that's what I'm going to do while we wait for the Wither Skeleton. While we wait for the Wither Skull, and then when we get back, will be a castle. I'll probably do something with this building. Hopefully soon I'll have made up for the fact that I didn't get to fight the Ender Dragon. And you will have something more exciting than that fight was. So, right, I'm going to be back when we have one more skull, and when we have a castle. So I will see you in a little while. Probably open these, otherwise I won't be able to get out. Oh, I should also mention, these are from Ancient Warfare as well. They're really functional. They're sometimes a little bit trippy. They're really cool. They also make my castle look really great. I like it. I should probably also, while we're here, I'll show you the rest of the castle. I don't know why I didn't. Up here is just a little beacon tower. Maybe I'll make it taller. I'm going to put some other stuff here. I'd like to make soldiers patrol the walls, and which I can do. I'd like soldiers to patrol the walls and to walk around the outside and to be walking on the roads over here. There's lots of things I'd like to do, but we will see about... Because for some reason, if I put an Ancient Warfare NPC down here, it just doesn't do anything. Like, even if I give it work orders, and all it does is go and stand frozen next to the nearest village block. So I don't know how to handle that. But when we can, I'll have soldiers patrol the walls. They'll go and sleep in there at night. And I may also... let me show you. There's a town just over here. We've talked about it before. I'm going to do something with this water, because there's a waterfall here and over there. And I'd like them to go into the village, the city, or the castle, rather. But I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet. So I just put these blocks around it. It looks a bit like a drain. There's this village here. And since it's next to the castle, I'd like to do some refurbishment on it. And perhaps make it into, I've always wanted to make this into a little village, an Ancient Warfare village, and use it for own purposes. But I think it's going to have stuff like an inn that might have some soldiers in there resting, stuff like that. But for now, this is what we've got, and I'm going to keep working on it. So I'm going to see you in a little while, and then we will go fight the Wither. I was doing some work on the palace, and, I don't think it's a palace, I think it's a castle. It's a very specific difference, I think. And we have three Wither Skulls. Not that chest, this chest. We have three Wither Skeleton Skulls. So, we can fight the Wither. And then, I guess that will be the end of this bonus episode. Maybe it'll be longer or shorter than a normal episode. I don't know yet. Because it's just a bonus, so that I don't have to keep feeling bad about the Ender thing. I'm going to put together the Wither. So I'm probably going to eat, make sure all of our armor's charged, make sure that both of our quivers are full. And then, we're going to go probably to the desert where I spawn and fight the Wither. I don't want to fight him around here because there's too much good stuff to destroy. This is the start on our castle. I like it so far. I'm going to make some changes to it. It's definitely got sort of like the imposing feel I wanted. I don't want it to be too fancy like a palace, but I also want it to be a little bit fancy. So I'm probably going to do some stuff with micro blocks, like to just break up the shapes a little bit. But so far I think I'm happy with it. And the inside's just dark right now because I haven't put anything in. But I've done the wall on the outside, and I've made a little entranceway so that you can walk along the walls up here to it. But so far, that's it. But I'm quite happy with it so far. Okay, let's get to work on Wither. I think I might have to go and get some soul sand from the end. Venomous skeleton, lovely. Not the end, from the Nether. And then we'll be good to go. Close this just so no one gets in. Okay, good. Let's go get what we need, and then I'll cut back when we are ready to fight the Wither. We have reached the sands of the desert, and we will be descending now. I've parked my ship, and it was night when we arrived, so I've slept in the bed, which means if we die, we'll be able to come back to the fight pretty quick. We're over the ocean, so that I can just drop down, but also because I was too lazy to move over there. It gets quite laggy sometimes when you fly the ship, so I didn't want to bring it too close to the land. I think as you get closer to the land, the more lag it has, I think, because it's trying to figure out where it should be compared to the higher mountains. Like, if you try and fly over a mountain, it starts freaking out. Anyway, let's fight the Wither. I haven't fought the Wither in a long time. I don't think I've ever done it in vanilla, because, well, that sounds like a lot of trouble to go through. I've gathered, I think it's like a T-shape of soul sand, and then the three skulls on the top. I think we can do this fairly easily. We've got a lot of protection. Let's I'll take these out. Oh, well, that was a surprising kind of cool. I'll go over here instead, though. I'm going to put the wither next to some quicksand, just in case maybe he wants to fly through it and not cause us any more trouble. Okay, wait, if I can... Oh, there's the wither. Let's go over here with our bow when he's finished. It doesn't take any hits right now. He's not taking hits right now. Oh, there he is. There's the wither. Oh, all withered. I think our sword will definitely be the right choice here. Good job we're doing this in the desert, not anywhere near our town. Okay, Mr. Wither. That's lovely. Thank you very much. Could you no longer do this? Alright, the bow. Go with the bow. He's putting us in a hole. This bow actually has wither on it, so we're currently withering the wither. I'm going to run around for a while, try and get some of our HP back. As long as he doesn't shoot at our ship, I don't mind what he does. Come on, you withery bugger. We died. Hopefully he's not going to come over here, that would be bad. There's no longer a wither fight symbol showing, so I think we have got far enough away. Oh, there's the wither fight symbol. Or I guess it's his health bar, which is almost full again, which sucks. Oh, don't fall in there. That won't help you with your fight. Wither seems to have frozen. This is really great. Maybe he's got in some quicksand. Actually, you know what? I think our bow fires so far that we're not aggroing him. That's wonderful. Oh, fuck off. I don't need you right now, thank you. Bloody cockatrice. Another one. You are not the most important thing I need to face right now. Every time we hit him, we have to move our bow up a little bit because he gets knocked so far back. Where'd he go? Wow, I don't know why he got over there. Okay, this method is far too slow. We're just knocking him further and further away, which means it takes longer and longer to kill him. Let's figure out some different tactics. Oh, this is not the day for a blood moon. I'm stuck in my own quicksand. This is the worst version of these events. Are we in quicksand? We are in quicksand. Looks like the wither will take any target. He's just attacking these random things. Okay, we died. Fortunately, we have this ship. I'm going to wait out the full... And that is where our footage ends, because my hard drive got filled up. Fortunately, I noticed it in time, and we still have the wither to fight, so no worries there. We are having a really hard time. Flying would be really helpful, but in order to get flying, I need to kill the wither. So let's keep at it. He's now regained all of his health. He's behind there. Yeah, my hard drive filled up, so we lost footage just after I said, I'm going to go and sleep through the blood moon. I did sleep through the blood moon, or rather I waited out the blood moon, because you can't actually sleep during the blood moon. It wasn't so bad. And then since the wither's moved, I went and got our stuff back. Blood moon sucks. What am I getting hit by? Oh, a cactus. Is this... Because this is a perfect position if he doesn't... Because he can get... Okay, no, I thought he would be... Oh, wow, 37 damage. Let's keep doing that. Okay, good. Yes, okay, great. We did it. Wonderful. I don't know why it worked so well that time. I guess maybe we're hitting him perfectly. Where the hell is our nether stuff? Our nether star. Did I pick it up? I did. Okay, great. And we got a division sigil, which we don't really need. Okay, that damn well better have captured. Good. Nether Star, Minute to Yellow Heart, all very good stuff. I think it was because we were now charging our shots completely, which we probably weren't in the past. Oh, I'm in quicksand. Don't like that. Yeah, okay, well then we fought the wither. That went well better. A lot better than I expected. So, we're almost coming to the end of our bonus episode. I'm going to take this up back to our normal home, back to our village. And then we will make flying, because that's the main reason I wanted to fight the Wither. Because it'll just help out in builds in future. I can just fly around instead of having to build up to everything. Yes, let's go back to our village. As we fly past this island, I'd like to mention I'm going to do something at some point with that island. I'm not sure what yet. I have ideas, but I think that might be where our dinosaurs go. I'm not certain. I may actually even convert it to an Arctic biome, which is not very easy. Basically, it involves replacing all the dirt with snow, like manually, and then maybe even some putting some cryothium underneath the soil so that everything stays frozen. And then I thought about putting some woolly mammoths, penguins, stuff like that on it, and having like a little our own little Arctic paradise, which doesn't sound appealing. I mean, the Arctic's not a nice place to be generally. But anyway, it's close enough to our base that I feel like I should do something with it. So I probably will. Not this episode, but at some point in the future. I also think that maybe dinosaurs might go over there behind the volcano, or even underground. Still thinking about it. Okay, we are home. And, oh, well, that was close. Probably not the best place to put our water spout. Actually, though, it hasn't caused any hassle. I had to put a... You can't see it because he's blocking it. Oh, yeah. I had to put a little hole with some grass in there because the sheep have eaten all of the grass in their pen. So hopefully it'll be able to re-spread out from there. That's it's a bit annoying though, because it doesn't look right. I hate chickens, they're everywhere now. While I was building, I forgot to turn off the chicken creator, and literally this whole place was covered in chickens. I was even getting a little bit of lag, which was really annoying. We can craft some wings. Let me show you wings. We're gonna make invisible wings. I don't want to have big wings sticking out of me. So that requires unstable ingots and gold and the nether star we just picked up and glass. So I'm gonna put this stuff together, and not the Mobius ingots, we'll have to do that on camera, because you can't take them out of your inventory, you can't do anything with them. If you close the window you're making them, it says there, if you close the window you're using them, making them in, then they'll just explode, and we don't want that. So let's make all this stuff and then we'll be back. Okay, here we go. I've made a normal crafting table because sometimes I don't know, I've had problems with Mobius ingots before where they didn't work because of the crafting table. I think it was because of the crafting table. Anyway, I don't want that to happen this time. So, this is the recipe. I think I can leave that on screen, it won't cause any problem. The first thing we need to do is make the Mobius ingots. I'm not sure I'll be fast enough to do this. As soon as we've got both, we need to put them in the right place. Put the diamond, the nether star and the glass. I might not talk, it might be quite tense. Let's go for it. We made it. Okay, we made it. Good. That was so close. That was about to explode. So now, if we hold this in our inventory, we can fly. And we also don't take fall damage. So that's great. I'm really happy about that. And it'll make things a lot easier in future. Did I just throw my bow? I think I did. Yeah, I did. I'm really happy with the ability to fight. Let's go look a little. Let's take this opportunity to have an aerial view of our village. For the first time, I mean, I go into creative and take aerial shots for the thumbnails, but, you know, the first time on camera. So, this is our village. Isn't it lovely? Okay, let's go to our castle over here. We're not very fast, which is why it might be worth making a jetpack. But, because jetpacks, you have power, so you can move forward a lot faster. If I press control, I think we go a little bit faster, but not much. This is our road leading to our little place, our little thingy-diggy. I was trying to look for the word barracks or maybe castle or something like that, but I couldn't find it. Let's see how our mob farm is doing. So they actually don't use that much coal. We can leave them going for a while. And I think they generate more coal than they spend. Like we've got 1.5 stacks of coal. So that's pretty cool. We've got two more wither skulls, so we can fight the wither again if we want. Yeah, we're starting to fill up the third chest. A lot of this stuff's crap, and I'll just filter it out, I guess. Like, I'll have it automatically destroyed. But some stuff's really great, like these uncommon loot chests. Let's pop these and see what we get. So we got two ender pearls, a bunch of splash potions, some that are useless to us, bane of arthropods, some gold. Actually, they might have been our gold originally. So that's cool. Chuck these in these chests. The top chest doesn't actually work, because... I need something back. What did I... Oh, yeah, there. Quivers. The top church doesn't actually work because it's against stone, but oh well. We can also, maybe we'll be able to make it while we're here, actually. So from doing this, we've also got a lot of the resource we might need to make another upgrade that I'd like to make pretty soon, which is additional heart containers, but you need red hearts, and then you turn that... Well, we got a yellow heart, but you have to convert a yellow heart into a red heart. I might have picked one up from fighting the Ender Dragon, but I must have, because I don't remember getting 5 yellow hearts. I might have missed them. I might be still on the ground, or maybe they just disappeared. Oh well. Well, anyway, we've got one yellow heart. We can actually fight the Wither whenever we want, and I might do it a little bit more to get some more... Like, we can do it right now if we want. I might do it a little bit more to get some more heart containers so we can just start doing the upgrades. But for now, let's leave it here. This is our castle, and we can fly now, which is exactly what I wanted out of this episode. We fought the Wither on camera, which is hopefully going to make up for the not fighting the Ender Dragon. Maybe I'll have to fight the Wither a couple times to make it even, because the Ender Dragon fight was really harsh. This is the start to our castle. I'm going to waste some arrows. This is the start to what will be the second village, and hopefully soon we'll set up trading between these two villages, but also first I need to set up couriers, which I think I'll just do off camera, and we'll, at the start of the next episode I'll talk to you about it. But yeah, we're in a fairly okay position. Stop wasting arrows. Okay, thank you very much for watching. I hope this bonus episode has made up for the mess-ups in the last episode. If you've enjoyed this episode, don't forget to like and subscribe, and leave a comment below if you've got any suggestions or ideas or recommendations or just general comments. Thank you very much for watching. This has been Gesture of None, and I will see you the day after tomorrow.